everybody, and welcome to Susan's Kitchen. Today we are doing a beautiful and very exciting show. I love it, and I think you will too. You are going to learn how to make fresh pasta at home for yourself from scratch. My guest in a minute, his name is Chef Fausto. He's a guy who owns a Pomodoro at the village market and the ice cream place upstairs. Chef, asante sana.
Hi, Susan.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are
thank
you?
Thank you very much. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for the invitation.
Thank you. Thank you. So you're going to teach us how to do fresh pasta.
Yeah, we are going to present today how to make fresh pasta.
Yes, please.
I mean, it's one of the most traditional things that you can find in Italy. All the mami in Italy, they are doing these things at home. So first of all, let me explain what we need to make pasta, fresh pasta. It's something very easy. We need, say for four people, we need 400 grams of flour, white flour, wheat flour, and four eggs. That means each 100 grams, we need one egg, and a little bit of salt. And then I have a fork here, because I want to show how to mix the egg without, that goes around and
yes,
running around.
Yeah. Running, yes.
So we take the flour.
Right onto the table.
Right onto the table.
Yes.
And we create a small, we call like a fountain.
Yes, yes,
we create an oval volcano, how do you say?
Yes, 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 the hole in the, hole in the middle of the, of
which
the mountain.
Which will host the eggs here.
Yes, yes.
And we put our egg.
Oh, lovely.
Fresh egg here.
Lovely, yes.
Here we don't need more. Now we take our fork.
Yes.
And we start to beat the egg.
Right in there.
Right in there. Ah! Because if you start to cover with the flour now,
yes,
you're going to mess everywhere. So
yes, that's right.
Slowly, slowly.
It collects. Slowly
collect
picks,
the flour.
Yeah.
And makes it big. This is the easier way. This time,
yeah,
we just add a little bit of salt.
Or salt.
Not too much.
Yes.
Because then we are going to put salt even in the water.
I see. Okay. Oh, yes.
Then we mix.
Slowly, gently.
We have to make sure that all the flour get inside together.
Inside, yeah.
Without breaking anything.
Yes.
And slowly, slowly. Okay, in kitchen you don't have to be in a hurry. You have to relax and enjoy cooking.
Yes.
That is the best way.
It is.
Cooking
it is
a passion.
So. It is, it is, it is. Yes.
Prepare your Sunday morning, because this is something that you have to do in Sunday.
Yes.
Comes better.
Yes, yes. Yes, because you have time, you're relaxed.
Yeah, you're relaxed, kids are sleeping.
And you have time to do it, yeah.
So slowly, slowly we go ahead more.
Yeah.
More.
Could I use the atta, you know the atta flour, the brown?
The brown flour, of course, you can use everything. Yeah. That is something up to you. I mean, you can decide. This is the traditional way you use the white flour.
White flour.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, it's getting thicker, 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 yeah, it's collecting. Yeah,
yeah. Now we try to mix together.
Yes. Oh, no, use your hands.
We put our hands here. Yeah. To mix.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. It's actually become stiff. It's become...
It's stiff, yes. Yeah. Sometimes the eggs are small. So what I suggest, to use a bit of water in case the four eggs are not enough in size to compensate all this, the flour that we have. We have to mix this like that for at least 15-20 minutes to make sure that you warm with your hands the dough and it comes very elastic.
Yes. 15-20 minutes, people, you hear that? That's good exercise. It's exercise, you know? You get your arms
that
get strong.
Nice. Hips like that.
Huh? Yeah, have a little dance.
Yeah, exactly, it's a dance.
If you don't do it for 15 minutes and you stop maybe after 2 minutes, it doesn't work
because at the end, if you don't give the time to the ingredients to combine together, to stay together, when you're going to cut, it will break all of it. Yeah, also when you're cooking, you face some problems, so you need time to mix. Very nice. Good. Nice.
Okay,
this is the first step.
Okay.
Okay, Susan, I just washed my hands.
Yes.
I removed all the excess of flour on my fingers.
Yes.
I'm going to show to see how to turn the dough.
Yes.
And in the way that we can mix at least for 15 minutes, this one. So first,
I
we
see.
Just press a bit and then come back,
you pull it
we
back.
Turn it oh, and quarter of circle,
yep.
And we do the same. Quarter of circle, ah. And we do the same. In case we need a little bit of flour,
yes.
Just do it like that.
Yes.
And this come better.
Yes. Yes, it doesn't stick.
Yeah. This is what we really have to do. It's coming very soft.
It is, huh?
Yeah, very elastic. Finally, we get a kind of ball.
Yes.
It's quite soft.
Yes. Can, yes. Yeah. Yes.
Now we need to rest a bit. Usually to rest, he has to be in a place where the air is not there. So we try to put this one like this, maybe a little bit of flat.
Yes.
And we cover with this one.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
And we leave to rest at least half an hour.
Half an hour.
30 minutes, yeah.
Welcome back, you're watching Susan's Kitchen. And if you missed the first part of the show, you will have missed the wonderful stuff that we're doing. We're doing homemade pasta. Chef Fausto with me here was teaching us how to do that from scratch, which is excellent. We've put it to rest and he's going to show us the remaining part of that a little bit later. But first we're going to do some peanut and spinach balls. Yeah, I'm going to start on that first.
Well.
Yeah. I'll start with the bread.
I'm curious.
Hmm? Yeah, no. This is simple. It is, yeah, thank you. It's simple, and I want to serve it with your pasta.
It works. For sure, 100%.
I imagined it in my head.
So you have to break all this bread like that, eh?
Yes.
Fantastic.
Yes, you do, yeah.
So this one you don't need any
yes,
more.
Yes, that's done. That's done. A little onion. Better put all of it. That's okay.
This is, you don't need.
This is cheese. Parmesan. Should I put a lot? This is garlic. That's garlic that's been nicely,
nice,
you know, grated. This is thyme. If you have dry, fresh thyme, it's okay. Just chop it and use it instead. I won't use too much. It might be strong, too strong. Yeah. All right. Spinach, ready cooked and, you know, squeezed out. So you get rid of most of the water.
So very dry, yeah?
Yes, quite dry. Quite dry because we have a lot of eggs which are going to come in. And then you mix it up and then we're going to form some balls. Can I ask you to do something for me, please?
Yes, please.
Will you grease? Will you, you know, grease with a little of the...
Butter.
Here, that's okay. Yeah. That's a little egg I put in there. This is a little margarine. Okay, this is a little wet. It's a little too wet. Could I send you to the fridge and get me some bread from the fridge, please?
Right here. Break one or two.
Yes. Yes, go ahead. Thank you. And then make some balls. What size is good?
I don't know, depends on you. Yeah, that size is okay.
Yeah.
Voila.
Yes, thank you. That's good.
It's nice.
Yeah.
Smell is good.
Mm? Yeah. And there's no meat. Yes. Over here, I'm using some Nutfields peanuts.
Okay.
This is, I like these people.
Yeah.
I like them.
Very nice.
Yes, I like them. And they also do macadamia and so many other things. Yes, please. Yes, please.
Enough, all of them?
Let's do all of them, yeah. See how it goes.
Okay.
This is a Rampton's machine.
It's a very nice machine.
Huh? Okay, that goes there.
Yep.
And then roll the balls in the peanuts that we've just chopped. Would you turn on the oven? I need the oven at 200 degrees.
200 degrees?
Yeah. And we'll put them in there for about 15 minutes.
Okay.
Okay. Yes, let's Let's put it in the oven. Yes, yes. It's good. Good. So close. It's going to be there. Yeah, it's going to be there for about 15 minutes.
15 minutes.
15 minutes, yeah. Okay, chef, you're going to come on this side.
Side.
And I want you to continue with your sauce.
Sauce. Today we are going to prepare a sauce with prawns, zucchini, and a tomato.
Zucchini.
It's simple sauce that yes. we can be ready in 5 minutes.
Yes.
And we are going, the first step is cleaning the vegetables.
Yes.
We just washed them.
I've washed them,
we remove
yes.
it, the first part, and then we can cut in a thin round.
So thin, round slices.
Slices,
yes.
This way. We say we prepare dough for 4 people.
Is it?
Yeah, that okay. dough is enough for 4 people. When we are talking about 4 eggs and 400 grams of flour, it's enough for 4 people.
4 people.
We are going now to prepare a sauce to for one single portion. So we need just
a little bit
yeah. of everything.
Yeah.
We are going to just to show how to cut the tomato in this particular needs.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah.
This is like this. This is the way.
That is nice because...
That is the beginning.
Yes.
That is the beginning. This is the pan.
Yes. Shall I put it on?
We can put on.
Yes.
And we are going to use a little bit of olive oil.
Olive.
Only extra virgin. Okay? The first
squeezing. Pressing of it. That's what extra virgin is.
Yeah. That is the meaning.
Yeah.
And we are going to put our zucchini this way. And we need our
things
to go ahead.
Yes.
Now we are going to clean the prawns. Prawns, I like everything of the prawns. Everything is good of the prawns. This is usually they use only the tail, but
yes. You like the whole piece.
We have to use this. This is the best. Here they have the best taste. Everything is the flavor comes from the head.
Yeah. head.
So don't throw it immediately.
Is it?
Yeah. Let it put it inside like that. Yeah.
So okay.
All the head like this. You wash carefully the prawns. Yeah, before doing that.
Yes.
And they are going to give it right
lovely.
Taste. Now we are going to remove this one.
The shell.
We can get only the tail.
Yes.
Where the meat is.
Yes. You took the tail off too. Oh,
yeah.
I see.
Remove all these things
and
here.
And the legs and the...
And the things out.
Yeah.
Very good. For this portion, I'm going to use, I said, 4, each person will be enough of this size. This is a special queen prawns.
Special queen prawns. Yes.
And if you put too much, then become heavy.
Yes.
Especially if you have another meal to eat.
Yes, okay.
So four of them of this size are more than enough.
Is enough.
For each person.
Yes.
So this is the way to clean. To clean nicely.
Yes.
The last things you have to do with the prawns, you have to remove the intestine.
Yes.
Because you know sometimes it's a bit how do you say bitter.
Yes.
Because it contains
the intestines are there.
Yeah. So you can.
So what are you doing?
This,
you're cutting the back.
Yeah. You have to remove these things inside here.
Mm-hmm.
You remove it.
Oh.
Yes. I open a bit.
At the top.
The top, just for decoration. Feel the. Smell the taste of it.
I know, I can.
Which is now we can put this one inside and you can finish to cook.
Okay.
We can also add our tomato.
No.
This is done.
Oh. I can
also. I put this one for the last, otherwise it's too strong the taste of the garlic.
Garlic.
Just to give a taste.
Yeah. And you left it whole.
Yeah. I leave it whole, yeah. We're going to cook nicely now. We leave to cook the prawns
a bit
until they become...
Shall I put the fire up again?
Please.
Yeah.
Wait a bit.
See, they're coming.
Yeah, they're opening. They're opening.
They give that.
Yes, a nice look.
They feel a bit.
Hmm? Ah.
The smell is there.
Yeah.
Now this is the time.
For the wine.
For the wine. It might create a bit of.
Yes.
Yeah.
Some vapor.
It's a nice glass, this one. Huh? Yeah, the smell is there. We leave the wine going.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
All the. We evaporate a bit.
So people don't get drunk, eh?
When exactly.
They eat the
problem. Last time to drink later. the a good glass of wine. Now, in this way, the head of the prawns give the right taste.
Huh? Yeah.
If you don't cook with that one, you never get that.
The flavor.
This is my sensation.
No,
this is my feeling.
I get you, yeah.
Now it's time to put a little bit of salt.
Yep.
If you like a little bit of pepper.
Pepper.
Remember, we are doing one portion.
One portion,
yeah,
that's
so
excellent.
Enough. I use tomato sauce that you can use, you can buy anywhere, tomato sauce. And we need just to give color to our final preparation.
Right. Right, yeah. Oh, that's lovely.
Now they are getting together, the flavors.
Okay.
This is done.
It is.
It's done.
All right, taking a small break. We'll be back shortly. Don't move from your seats. Welcome back. You're watching Susan's Kitchen. We've been making wonderful pasta today for you, teaching you how to cook from scratch your own pasta. And Chef Fausto, who had joined me earlier, he's still with me here. Chef Fausto, asante again.
Thank you very
Thank
much,
you.
Susan. Okay, now we are going to do pasta, real pasta. Now we are going to see what we have done up to now.
Yeah.
So we are going to remove the dough we have mixed before.
Yes.
We are going to put a little bit of flour, Luis.
Yes.
Now, what we do this one.
Yes, you fold it.
We fold it a bit. And we are going to pass to this, through these two rolls.
Yeah.
They will make it.
Yeah. It's like a press.
Exactly. It's going to make it flat. Remember always flour. We need a lot of flour. Otherwise it will stick in the machine. And
then you have to try to put your fingers and something. And
we have to do it three times at the same size, fast.
Is it? Wow.
Mm. And all the time you turn it.
You turn it, yeah.
Flour.
Yes.
And we are going to another size, moving this.
Oh, that controls the
control,
size?
Yes.
The size of the width in the thickness.
The size of the two rolls, they are turning together.
Yes, yes.
So we pass this one again.
So now, did you make it smaller,
smaller
or bigger?
Smaller. Smaller. We are going from the bigger to the smaller.
Oh.
And we are looking for our size.
Yes.
You know? Yes. Now, since it's too long, we can even cut it. We can show nicely.
Right.
Because it's going to
it's
be,
going to be quite thin.
Very thin. Then we are going to the last hole, which is this one. This is the thickness we are looking for.
Yes.
It's basically it's half millimeters.
Wow.
Sorry, half centimeter is too big. Here we can decide to do whatever we want. We can do tagliolini, which is the smaller size, small spaghetti.
Yeah.
It's called tagliolini.
Tagliolini.
We have a tagliatelle.
Yes.
Which is a big size, 8 millimeters thick. And then we can cut ourselves with a knife and get the size that we want for making pappardelle, which are a little bit bigger.
Wow.
And we can cut in this way.
I think we've come a long way with cooking. Long way.
This is called pappardelle. It's a little
I've
bit bigger.
I've never seen big ones like this.
And then we can remove immediately. We have to immediately open.
Yes, so it doesn't.
It doesn't stick to it.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
But this is done by hands.
Yes.
We have to show a bit because before was done like that.
Of course, yes, yes.
The preparation was done by hands. For the rest, we are going to cut. For our recipe, we need a tagliatelle.
Okay.
And we are going to use this size.
That one, yes.
It is 8 millimeters size.
Okay.
So, we move our...
to the next roller.
Roller. We are going to place our things like this. We place this one slowly. And we are going to turn.
Oh.
I try to show to the camera now.
Yeah. It's coming out.
Slowly, slowly.
Oh.
To you, Susan.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. Lovely. Look. Huh?
This is the size of tagliatelle.
That's lovely.
We add a little bit of salt in the water.
Yes, please.
Whenever we cook pasta, we have to add
a little salt.
Since the water is not too much, I think that this is enough.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to take mine.
Yes. Shall I bring another one?
Yes.
Or
yes,
how
yes.
many? Do we do all of them at the same time?
All the same time.
At the same time?
Yeah.
Ah! Don't stick together, please.
No, don't worry. They come in the water and they. Great. Hey, yeah. Inside. All of them.
I like that.
So we mix a bit to avoid that they stick together.
Yes.
2 minutes. And it will be ready.
Really? Really?
Because it's really
boiling
fresh.
Water. Yeah. Yeah.
Usually dry pasta, which you buy spaghetti, or it takes about 12, 13 minutes to be cooked.
Yes.
Fresh pasta, 2-3 minutes. 4 minutes maximum, if they're a little bit dry,
yeah,
it will be enough.
Yeah.
I take some of this one, which is ready, and I pour in my
salt. Oh, I see. I was waiting to see what you're going to do. That's great.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. I just need a little bit, not much at all. Yeah.
This is,
That's
you
fine.
Can even switch off.
Okay, yes.
Now we can add a little bit of parsley.
Yes.
I like parsley.
Yes.
And a little bit of olive oil still.
Ooh. Sometimes it's loose and it falls off and,
So I got used to that.
I like
so,
that, I can smell that, I can smell that.
So we have, we can...
we're done.
We
I think
done.
We can we plate now?
We can plate.
Can
it.
We plate?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to take 2 minutes just to do our plating, so don't move away. Well, we've come to the end of the show, and I have really enjoyed it. I hope you at home have watched and seen how you can do that wonderful pasta that Chef was showing us how to do. We're going to do finishing touches to this. I think, Chef, you want to do a little pepper?
Yeah.
Yeah?
This is the last touch.
Yeah?
We can do it.
Oh, all right. And I've got this. It's an Italian creamy dressing from Knorr. And what I thought is I would drizzle. I drizzle some of it. Do a bit of that on there. Chef, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
I'm
you
glad. Thank you for watching. For the recipes, please go to my website, www.kenyankitchen.co.ke, and get the magazine, please. It's called Kenyan Kitchen. It'll have the recipes in there. Collect them and use them 3 years, 4 years down the line, and then grow the recipes with your own touches. All right? Well, we'll see you next time. And thanks again, Chef.
Thank you.
Thank you. See you next time.